Hello everybody, I'm Rockman, and I'm reusing an intro sequence. We're back with Xenoblade Chronicles. Last time, we went and helped some worker guy with not dying. And then Melia went off to a tomb, and now she's gonna die. Now we have to save her. That's what we're doing this episode. But first, we're gonna run down here once more, through this hall of entrance to the capital. Imperial Palace, that's what it's called. Because we want to do something. Yeah, if you see on our map there, there's a store, and I haven't been through the store yet, so I'm going to do that. Let's see what he has. He has a popular staff for Melia, who we can't check out right now. Wait, can he? No. Oh yeah, sorry. Yeah, I messed up. He has an Ace Lancer for Ryan, a Hunting Nibbler for Ricky, which is quite useful, I guess. And an Iron Cutlass for Dumban. So I guess Charlotte misses out. He also has Sky Gear of every variety. He has Aerith Gear for Hat. Ocean Earrings for Hat. Unique Gear, Ether Up 2, could be useful. Swimming Top. Ether Armor. Or Aerith. Did I say Ether? Aerith Armor, yeah. Earth Gauntlets, Mithril Gauntlets, and Gravity Stone Bands. Let's see what shorts, Swimming Bottoms, Earth Leggings, Earth Boots, Mithril Boots, and Hover Shoes. And he also has a whole bunch of spellbooks for Melia. But, since I'm showing this off, I'm going to go and update our gear now, so I will see you in a moment. Alright, I redid everyone's gear. I went and got everyone a set of Sky Gear because it seemed pretty good. I saw a lot of blue and not a lot of red on everyone, so I did that. As for the gems, I stuffed Shulk full of Quick Step gems, now he moves super fast. Gave him some back attack for his backslash, double attack so we might be able to attack twice. Initial tension since I use him a lot, like to play as, so like battles and stuff. Ryan, I just gave him a bunch of strength gems because I don't know what to do with him. I mean, he's good, but I just don't know. I'm trying to make him like an attacker, not like a tank. Dunban, I gave him a ton of agility gems because he's an agility tank, so I figured, hey, why not increase what he's good at and stuff? So, yeah, that's him. Charlotte, I just gave her a bunch of like art seals and ether defense, a little spike there. And Ricky, I just almost maxed out his HP with HP gems. So yeah, that's everyone. But if we look at Charlotte, she has a ton of gems on her. And with that, having like nine, wait, is that nine gems? Yeah, nine, is it? Wait. I think I'm just dumb. Eight. Okay, yeah, I'm just dumb. Eight gems, not nine. What am I thinking? Anyway, it was eight gems on her. Truly outrageous. It's an achievement. We got it. But yeah. Wow. Can't believe I miscounted that. Anywho, let's go onwards. Or downwards. To where we need to go, which is down here. Because we need to go back to Aerith Sea. To go help Melia, I guess. Yeah, main entrance. Go us. We're there. Shulk moves super fast. Look how far behind those guys are. Alright, now that we're back out here to the central gate, or center gate, instead of going off one of those other teleporters like over there like we usually go, we're gonna go down. And over there in the distance, you can see where we need to go. The High Entia Tomb. Through this teleporter. Let's go. And with that, Dumban learns a skill, and
this is the tomb. Defensive measures prevent intruders from entering. You will have to circumvent these to move within the tomb.
One thing before we enter. Alvis, you can see the future like me.
I am from a long line of seers dedicated to serving the Imperial family. My visions help to protect the Empire.
But you're Homs.
Yes. But that is for another time. My ancestry is not easily explained. And my ability to see the future is equally complicated. You might say, I have my own ritual. Is it not the same for you?
No. My visions appear suddenly, without warning. At first, they're obscure. Then, as it gets closer to the event, I start to understand.
It seems you possess a power greater than I. I still have not seen any danger befall Her Highness.
Not much use as a seer then, are you?
Nothing passes you by, does it? Now you see why I asked for your help. What a lucky coincidence that I happened to see you in danger.
A coincidence?
But I've seen you use the Monado.
The Monado has been passed down the Imperial line for generations. The sword of the Bionis. It is compelled to do its master's bidding. Magnified greatly, it has the power to control the very fabric of our world. Ether. Control the ether, and your will is made reality. I willed it, and it happened. That is all. Perhaps due to that power, the High Entia sealed away the Monado for centuries. Eventually, it found its way into the hands of the Homs, and then you, Shulk. A coincidence, or something more. You must discover this yourself, for you are the one who wields the Monado. The Bionis is stirring.
The ancestral altar lies deep beneath the seals. What trials await me, I wonder? I must not lose focus.
Okay then, I guess we're playing a solo Melia, but just like with our team, I'm going to redo her gear quickly, so I will see you in a second. Alright, just like our other guys, I fitted her with a Sky series of gear, with tons of ether ups, because she's ether, with the exception of her Empress mask, because if you check it, and try to equip it, you cannot remove it, so we're stuck with that. Oh, okay, tomb approach. Apparently, I missed that. Now on top of this, I don't understand why they add the segment, because we walked down like, I don't know, 5 feet, maybe? No. Probably more than that, but not a long distance, just to push this button, just to get this.
I have come to be judged on my legitimacy to the throne by the ancestral spirits.
Permission granted. Commencing analysis of genetic data.
It's so cold.
There are remnants of ancient spirits in here. This is no ordinary chill.
As I explained before, Dunban, the defense systems are designed to prevent uninvited...
Well, what does this do?
Don't touch!
Thank you.
And with that cutscene over, we're fighting with Melia alone again. Fighting with Melia alone, we can use her discharges to do damage, and it's a good idea to put sleep on people. So yeah. Tasty sausage. But I don't understand why they put that little walking segment with Melia. It just seemed kind of pointless to me, because it just goes right back to a cutscene. But anyways, we're at the Hall of Spirits. Now, Melia's father was like, no one lived here for ages, but level 32 monsters that don't even pay attention to you. The most deadly of creatures. I mean, we can just sit here and build up our elemental bursts, but yeah. It's a thing. It noticed us. Oh no. But yeah. The hardest of enemies, if we want, because we're fighting alone. Just put him back to sleep. He's not going to notice us. But yeah. The hardest of enemies. Can I kill him with this? No, I can't. And he's dead. Okay. And it's nighttime. How we're able to tell it's nighttime in this tomb, I have no idea. But we can. So yeah. But anyways, on to the next tomb trials. And item orbs. What's this one have? Blue ladybird. That sounds pretty. Anywho, at the Hall of Trials of Super Difficulty, we have a split pathway here. Both leading to the exact same place. So, doesn't matter which side you take. Another glowing pathway of light appears. I should have mentioned that. Glowing pathways of light. Yay. And when we walk here, we have Hover Astas. And just like with that other guy, we can just stand here and build up our things. It's pretty easy, really, but they won't notice us until we get closer. Sorry if this is boring, it's really nice to get my elemental discharges. Or our elemental discharges. If you want to be part of this too, you can. But yeah. Boring. Might cut this out, probably won't. Okay, there we are. All ready to go. And he's dead. Yeah. Is this the final one? No, it's not the final one. That's why it's the only one here, Melia. Baka. We're almost to a burst, an elemental burst. I think I'll use this. And elemental burst time. And let's finish this burst end. Yeah. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Some sick loot. Nice. Anywho, let's go through here. According to that magical orange crazy taxi arrow, we're almost at where we need to be. Ceremony Hall, and we get an achievement, Specialist. Don't know what that's for.
You have done well, my descendant.
Descendant? Are you the progenitor of Antiqua?
Think of me as a recreation of said ancestor, possessing his thoughts and speech.
But he passed away thousands of years ago.
Do not mistake me for a living being. I am a replica of your ancestor. I am merely a projection of what he would be if you were to meet him now.
I do not understand. But I do not suspect any falsehood in your words.
It is beyond doubt. If I could feel, I would feel joy. I am not real, but I do not lie.
Joy? What do you mean?
The results of the gene analysis show Hom's gene integration of 80%. Estimates suggest evolution within 8 generations. Our wishes are almost fulfilled.
Wishes?
Our purpose, as decreed by the Bionis, is linked to our genetic sequence. We have spent millennia analyzing sequences to free ourselves from the curse. Only a certain gene set will unlock the mechanism and set us free.
I still do not understand.
It is of no consequence. I grant you this seal.
Is this?
It is you who will rule the High Entia, and likely be their last.
Revered ancestor, I...
Go forth and rule, my descendant.
So the spirits look favorably upon you. Explain yourself. Only Imperials are permitted to enter this place. I am the subject of Her Highness the First Consort. I need no permission. Mother's subject? No impure child of the Second Consort has the right to refer to the First Consort as Mother. A filthy Homs half-breed have no right to the throne.
Who puts a great big hole somewhere like that?
As I explained, it's a defense mechanism.
What a mess, Rhine.
Friend, not clever touching button.
I'm with these guys, Rhine.
How was I supposed to know that was gonna happen? What about your visions, eh? You think the two of you could come up with something?
You know it doesn't work like that.
It would have been useful, yes.
Pair of fortune-telling frauds.
You got us into this mess. And it's not the first time either.
Ricky, agree with Shulk.
Why is it my fault all of a sudden?
This time it is your fault.
Precisely.
Well...
Be thankful that we are all alive. I suggest greater care next time. Our journey will be longer, but we can still make our way deeper into the tomb.
Okay. We can't waste another second. Melia needs us.
Alright, back to our main team. Ooh. Rhine learned a skill. I think, actually... Yep, Shulk maxed out his skill tree. Rhine maxed out his. And... everyone's about the same, but... going from here on out, you want to go to your arts, or at least you want to, and you want to upgrade your shield to level 3. Just a heads up. Let's go forward and help Melia. And stuff. By walking through walls. Wanna go... oh, okay. A vision! We've collected 5 green diodes. Let's get to the Naroth for deciphering machine thing. Apparently we have to make a deciphering machine in the future. Alright, but now let's go down here and just jump down because there's water. And I'm lazy. Yeah. You want to be careful here because in the walls there's bad guys. And if you go here, a bad guy falls down and tries to attack you. But... we don't care about him. We want to go to the Valley of Emperors and grab onto this wall because they'll forget you. Now you just want to shimmy along here. This wall makes a weird noise when you shimmy on it. Is that what it's called, shimmying? Or is that when you stand and go against a wall? What's this, climbing? Just climbing? Okay. Tasty sausage magically in a tomb that's like closed for over 2,000 years. How it's still tasty, I do not know. But it is. It's there. Benny who? A big ball of glowing electric light. Alright, Orluga Rufus. He's big, he's not too bad actually. He's resistant, not immune, resistant to break, so you can only topple him in chain attacks. So yeah, you just want to let those guys take care of him with like the aggro, and you just want to stand back here with Shulk. Don't even have to play with Shulk actually. We've been playing with Shulk a lot. I just like being in control of him. He has Monado Arts. I really need to start playing with other people though. That sounds kind of dirty, but okay. Yeah, Rufus. As I said, not too bad. Get rid of some aggro there, because he attacked me, or not attacked me, but looked at me for a second. That has me spooked. And a chain attack. Let's do this. I don't believe he has any spikes. He might. Nope, he doesn't. And daze. Holy cow. What should we do? Sword drive. Okay. What do you do? Let's go with Tempest Kick. Okay. Why not? Let's finish this. The Monado Buster!
Anyone would think we're not wanted. Are we ever gonna find her?
I think you'll find we had to take the long way because somebody pushed a certain button.
Somebody mean Ryan.
Shut it, Hairball. It was just a button.
Relax. She will be fine. This route will lead us to the ritual altar. But time is of the essence.
We've got to hurry. There's no time to lose.
Alright, no time left to lose and... Holy cow. Achievements up the wazoo this episode. Like before, we just want to climb on these walls. All the way to that door. Didn't really show it off, but since these guys aren't of High Entia descent, they can't activate those little glowing pathways of light. I could probably show it off in a second. Yeah, I can. With that little floor there. Can we jump? Yes, we can. See? No light. Okay. Now through here... Is it through here? Which pathway is it? Okay. I'm going to quickly take care of these guys. Now that all those nuisances are out of the way, you might notice there's a pathway here that isn't on the map. You really want to go back here, because there's a tasty sausage. And... The second treasury! In the second treasury is a High Entia Tomb thing. And inside it's a level 10 art book for Summon Bolt. And Ruby Glasses. But mostly the Summon Bolt. And this guy, who I'm not going to deal with right now. See you later, nerd. But yeah, there's that. You want to get that. And now at the Tower of Trials bridge. And more climbing. Bye, dumb man. There he is. He's fine. He's fine. Once you get up here, we have another Orluga Rufus. So, we already fought this guy, so I think I'll see you once he's dead.
Piece of cake, but we mustn't be careless.
Alright, he's down. Some more stuff. It's really easy with these guys. Bunch of attackers. Bunch of jokers. Another blue ladybird. I wonder what that would look like in real life. Or even in this game. Anywho, another Orluga Rufus. Just like that one below it. I'll see you in a second.
Right, let's do this. Pretty good battle. Let's stay focused. Let's not lose our heads though.
Alright. Once again they're down. Some more stuff in these chests. Oh, okay. A vision. That's 3 Rufus control units we need. We can trade these for the secret club card. Alright, looks like our guys are going to the club later in their journey. We'll get to that eventually. Anywho, up here we have a button again. Which opens a door. Or invisible is a door. Hey, we've been here before. It's like it all loops together. We've gone full circle. Anywho, as that arrow indicates, we are almost to our goal.
Filthy Homs half-breed has no right to the throne!
Melia! Half Homs!
When you're about to meet your death.
Alright, behold, the most annoying boss battle in the game. I'm gonna switch out Dumban for Charl here. I feel like it'd be good to have Melia in the party just because it's kind of like her fight, but I think these three are really good with each other, and we need Charlotte definitely for the heals. I'll explain why. Why? We're fighting Telethia, and unless I got my information wrong, we need Purge for it. But with Shulk, we're fighting Tyrea, who is a person of Ionis, so we can't attack her with a Minado at all. So this fight's really annoying. Although if we can build up a chain attack nice and quick, we can hopefully get this Telethia into a topple. But yeah, really annoying fight. But once you can take down the Telethia, it's pretty easy. It's just long. So actually, once we take down the Telethia, I might just cut. Because yeah, it'd just be like half an hour of everything just bouncing off of Tyrea. Let's use Time Swipe Sword Drive. Oh, nice. What's Charlotte gonna do? Let's do heal round. Oh, nice. Backslash. Nice. Let's do another purge while we can, and then let's try to get that down. Okay, that was a waste. Everyone focus on the Telethia, please. I don't need the aggro. I'm not meant for the aggro, I'm Shulk. Charlotte, do your job and heal, please. But yeah, this fight's really annoying because of the hole. And now everyone's missing. Okay, let's focus on Tyrea, please. Just so I can build up my thing. Come on. One more hit. Okay. Purge time. There we go. Oh, let's heal Ryan again. Let me get rid of the aggro, and he has a vision. Flying bee. Shell's gonna die. And she's toppled. Oh, what are we gonna do? I don't want to focus on her, I want to focus on the Telethia. Shell is dead. Or not. Come on, let's heal you. This guy has a level 3 talent art, he hasn't used it yet though. That's why you need the shield. Or it's recommended you have shield. No one's toppled. And we missed. And I don't know, let's heal blast Ryan. Really annoying fight, as I said. I don't know what more to talk about here. Let's just hope Ryan keeps the aggro. Charlotte, you could really do your job right now and heal Ryan, or not. Thanks, Charlotte. Come on, Charla, heals. Please. If Ryan could take the aggro again, be appreciated. Let's purge. Yeah, once you take down the Telethi, this fight isn't so bad, it's just annoying. This fight's, nah, I mentioned it like 3 times, but it's true. Charla's almost dead, and we're all toppled. And this is the part where he kills us. Oh, wow. 2 whole damage. Let's do this. Come on, guys. Stop focusing on me. Stop focusing on me, Telethia, thank you. And Charlotte's dead. Charlotte, do your gosh darn job and heal us for Pete's sake. Let's do this. Yay, aggro. And this is the part where we die. Yep, we are dead. Well, I will see you back here in a moment. I was hoping I could do this in one try, but I couldn't. Alright, back with take 2 of this boss battle and stuff. Things are going slightly more smoothly. Slightly is keyword here. Everyone's about to die again. But at least I'm able to, like, heal them. Energy drain on Charla. 2 damage. Not bad. Ryan's dead. Come on, Ryan. Get up. Let's heal Charla. I'm gonna die. Come on, Telethi just has to die, and then we pretty much win. Okay. And now time for the fun stuff. Well, come on, Charla. Come on, heal yourself. Please, don't make me do this. Pretty much just want to build up your party gauge. Shulk. Do 1 damage. Flying bee on Ryan, he's going to get killed. So let's change the future. Come on. Ryan, you're up. Change that future, and it's done. Yeah. And now we just get to hear her scream. Another annoying aspect to this fight. Wait, what am I warning Charlotte from? Okay, I have vision again. Energy drain. I might just cut this out, because it's really boring. Because we're literally just standing here poking her. She can't even really do much. So I will see you when Tyrae is dead. Alright, it looks like Tyrae is practically dead. So, come on, there we go.
Almost bought it.
Alvis, thank you.
My pleasure, Shulk.
Why did you come?
The Monado gave me a warning that you were in danger. I'm just glad we made it.
Hey, Shulk, whoever that was is gone.
So, they escaped.
Shulk. Everyone, I thank you. You saved me.
Ricky, Smiley, Smiley! Millie, all safe! All thanks to Hero Pawn!
Oh, oh. That's not how I remember it, Cheeseball.
And that concludes my report on events in the tomb.
So, there are forces working in the shadows.
However, this is purely circumstantial. Nothing can be proven.
Inquisitors of the Bionite Order, dedicated and devoted to the Bionis.
The Order was dissolved under the rule of the Emperor Lumion, 47th successor to the throne, due to its extreme practices.
Like puppet masters pulling the strings from the shadows. I believe their bloodline was lost to the ages.
Her Highness the First Consort is currently residing in the Tower of Investigation. The Ministry of Investigation's judgment should be imminent.
Well, that may not be enough. I myself must shine a light on the truth.
Agreed.
Mother.
Melia.
Your Majesty.
You have returned unharmed from the tomb. The forefathers have spoken.
But if it hadn't been for Shulk...
Kallion has informed me of what happened. There is no reason to doubt your legitimacy to the throne.
Believe in yourself, Crown Princess.
Brother...
Tomorrow will be the investiture ceremony. At the appointed time, you will become my successor. Be proud.
I will.
Melia, my child, I am overjoyed at how far you have come. You are truly worthy of the throne. Continue the legacy of your High Entia and Hom's bloodline. You are the hope of Bionis.
Thank you.
Ricky and friends helped save Melly. Ricky very happy.
We're all relieved. But something's still bothering me.
What is it?
Why was Melia chosen as the Crown Princess? Shouldn't Kallion have been the one to ascend? And her foe in the tomb clearly opposed that decision.
You have a point.
Kallion is more than a worthy candidate. What reason could they have for choosing Melia? And why would Kallion go along with this?
It's a mystery.
Our apologies. His Majesty the Emperor summons you.
Finally! He's gonna let us into Prison Island. Yeah.
His Majesty awaits you in the audience chamber. He asks that you join him shortly.
Well, why not? Let's join him right now. I'm going down here once again to this portal, and this time I'm not going to end on it. Yeah. So, after that boss fight's done, I don't know what's going to go with that there. That's a really annoying boss fight. Once again mentioning it, but I don't like it. Like, if I could deal with both Tyrea and the Talethia at the exact same time, it wouldn't be that bad, but I don't know. And who I'm done mentioning that boss fight. Here we are. Let's go up here, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.
Shulk, forgive us for detaining you earlier. You and I are not of the same people. But this I must say.
Thank you for helping Melia Antiqua, my daughter.
It was no small feat.
Not at all. I too must apologize for meddling in your customs. We should not have interfered.
She is a lucky girl to have met such unselfish people. In the times to come, a ruler will need support from individuals like you. I hear you seek the Mekon.
Yes. The Mekon devastated our homes, and we lost many loved ones.
Revenge is your goal?
It is.
You are honest.
I do not want to hide our true intentions. Our very existence is at stake.
Unwavering, too. Shulk, you are the master of the Monado. But there is something that must be said.
What is it?
Long before our forefathers built this empire, two titans, the Bionis and the Mekonis, fought a vicious battle. Is this known among Homs?
Yes. It is told to us as children. The two fought and died, killing many creatures in the process. Their remains became our worlds, bringing forth new life on Bionis. That's how we were made.
The Bionis shall awaken once again.
Alvis told me the same thing.
This is not just the vision of a seer. All of Machna knows. The Talethia are as old as the Bionis itself. And now, they disturb the ether. That disturbance can only lead to one thing.
But why is this happening now?
This is an inscription left by our forefathers. It is written,
Descendants of Antiqua, when the ether cries, the Bionis awakes.
Mistake not the signs, and heed the sword's return. Trap its power, and assure eternal prosperity. All life born on Bionis affects the ether. The Mekon's assault is just the beginning. And these events were set in motion when you used the sword against them.
We used it because we...
Because you needed to. Without it, you could not survive. I cannot dispute this fact. I believe the inscription speaks of these very events with the Mekon. But if their assault continues, if more lives are lost, soon the Bionis will awake. And not only the High Entia, but all life will perish. Do you see, Shulk?
You're talking about total extinction.
Correct. Which is why the Mekon's invasion must be stopped.
Then you'll help us. Your Majesty, we need Imperial sanction to enter Prison Island. Will you permit us entry?
What will you do there?
I saw it in a vision. We will fight a faced Mekon. They must pay for what they did.
Then you will have seen him too. On Prison Island, our forefathers sealed something away, just as they did to the Monado. All records have been lost, and there is now no way to know what it was.
Is it connected to the awakening of the Bionis?
I do not know, but our forefathers must have had good reason. We must trust their decision. Shulk, allow me some time to deliberate. Above all else, I will consider the safety of Bionis. You are our Bionis brethren. We will not ignore your plight.
I understand. This is not our homeland. If you decide not to let us go, I will accept your decision.
I am sorry.
It's okay.
One more thing.
Yes?
I ask this not as Emperor Sorian Antiqua, but as a father. I do not demand that you act as Melia's protector, but I would be honored if you would be her friend. This is my humble request.
It would be my honor.
The Telethia are on the move.
Yes.
That fleshy fool will go for the Monado. What of the faces?
Repairs to metal are complete.
And Nemesis?
Nemesis is...
The Homs with the Monado. He has reached Erith Sea?
Yes.
Then there is only one place for them to go. Yet he will not dare unleash such power. No matter. Bugs must still be exterminated. It is time to test our new toy. Commence the assault on Bionis. Thank you.